Alright, it's a little bit different than HVAC today, but this is what we're changing this reservoir. It's leaking. I tried to patch it, didn't work, but it's dripping all down through there. So I got everything set up that I'm going to need, hopefully. I'm not a mechanic, so we're going to see how this goes. First thing we're going to do is pump the coolant that's in here out somehow. Alright, this is what I came up with. We're going to pump it right into this here. See how that works. Actually worked. Got all the coolant out of it into this thing. Move it out of the way. Now I gotta figure out how to get these clips off of here. Once again, I am not a mechanic. Come on. You're almost there.
Need a bigger screwdriver.
Alright. There's one of them. This one's not being as friendly. Come on now. Of course, the first one's going to pop right off. The second one's going to be a pain in the ass. I'm just going back with regular hose clamps. I talked to one of my buddies, it's a mechanic, and he said, if you're going to use a regular hose clamp, it'll be just fine. So that's what we're going to go with. If I can ever get this one off of here. Want it? Come on. It's already kind of warm out. Haha, got it. Okay, got that part done. Socket for this, 13 millimeter. Just thread in there, I guess. The part I'm most worried about is this hose on the bottom. I don't know how well that's gonna go. So. Not to, to drop this when I get it out of there. Okay. So if I can get these hoses off. There's one. There's two. Oh. And you want to keep it upright. Just FYI. We'll just set it right there. This one. Oh. Was good until I decided to screw with it. I set it right there. Now we have to get this little clamp off. I kind of quickly watched a YouTube video. It kind of helped a little bit. It'd be a lot easier if the screwdriver wasn't so long. This is my screwdriver for spinning condenser fan blades to see if they locked up or not. But it should just pop right off of there. I don't want to tear the hose up either. That's what I'm mostly worried about. Alright, let's try this. There we go. I think. Yeah. I might be able to reuse that clamp. Possibly. I can get the thing off of there. Okay. Well, I still have a little bit of coil in it. So gonna probably spill out. I'll try to catch it. And you don't want this hose. You want it to stay vertical, because if it falls over like the other ones, it will leak a bunch of coolant out. Okay, keep it upright. Okay, so we got the replacement one right here. we'll start with that bottom hose. I think I'm just gonna go with the hose clamp, which this one might be a little bit too big. We'll see here. Yeah, I think it's gonna tighten the way I want it to. Let me check and see if I have one a little bit smaller. Alright, so this is the next smallest one I have. We'll try it and see how it does. So there's a little notch in this hose right here, and there's also a notch in the tank right here. So you gotta get that notch in the right spot so it's completely fully seated up against the bottom of this. Friendly. I put a different kind of clamp on there. See if we can make it work. Seated up against that. Work this around here. I'm gonna snug it up with my impact, and then I'll finish with the nut driver. Because I do not want to break this. Set this back in place. Put our bolt back in. You guys probably just been seeing the back of my head the whole time. Get that snug down. Pop these off. I'll try to pop them off. I got a couple different options for these.
Let me get these ones off of there.
So I got these universal quick connect hose clamps. I want to try them. They don't work. I'll go with just a regular hose clamp. So I don't like the way that's just moving so easily. It seems to still be in place.
You stay there. So you, I think, are actually supposed to be in there. Okay.
So we'll put this on there. Fit it up. That. Yeah, that's just not tight enough. Way too loose. Need to go and need to downsize. Something like that, probably. I swear I don't feel like it's going to move, but I don't be wanna be rolling down the interstate and it decide to pop off. Wouldn't be good. Let's try this one instead. I think we're going to be okay there. So, let's see. This is how it's going to work. And then there's this one. So this is the one I want for this one. I'm already seeing what I did wrong. Should have done this back hose first. But I didn't. Fill it up
and turn it on and make sure there's no leaks. I hope there's no leaks. I hate working on cars. Can't stand it. Alright, let me get my keys and we'll turn her on. Call that a win. If it looks like it's dropping, but me. And we'll get everything cleaned up and go and try to enjoy the rest of my Saturday. Thanks for watching.